Hi friends, welcome back to my channel for a new video tutorial about supply chain analytics. Today, we will look at the impact of process variability on your supply chain resilience. The video is inspired by an article that you can find in the performance management section of my blog. I have put the link in the description down below. Let's take the example of the global supply chain network of a clothing retailer. You have stores all around the world that are replenished by regional and global warehouses, storing goods produced in factories. Planners send replenishment orders or delivery orders to replenish warehouses and stores. We will focus here on the store delivery and understand what can impact your logistic performance. First, let's introduce some concepts. Why do we need to control the delivery time? Suppose that you are in charge of managing the inventory of one store. You are facing some variability in your demand. Let's assume that it's following a normal distribution with a mean and a standard deviation. You want to set up a replenishment rule in your ERP. You choose order point, order quantity. When your order inventory is below a certain threshold, we call it the safety stock, your ERP will order queue units to replenish the stock. And after a certain time, that we can call delivery time, your store receives the order. The most important parameter here is the safety stock. Its role is to cover the demand during the replenishment lead time or delivery lead time from the warehouse perspective. It will depend on the variability of your demand, so the standard deviation, but also on the replenishment lead time. So, if in the mind of the inventory manager, the lead time is stable and equal to the target, we'll make sure that in reality it's the same. If not, you may face some stockouts. So, this is what we need to figure out. Understand the difference between the expectation and the reality. A supply chain can be defined as several parties exchanging flows of material and information through different systems. Thus, to follow the shipments, we can connect to these different systems to extract timestamps to follow the performance of each leg of your distribution network. Everything starts from the order creation and transmission. As soon as received and available in the WMS, your order can be prepared by the warehouse preparation team. It starts from picking and it ends at packing. Then, when the pallet is ready for shipping, the transportation team takes the ownership of the shipment, from the time it leaves the warehouse until the store delivery. Another timestamp can be captured when the goods are received by the store team in the system. Before starting to measure the performance, you need to fix target, so target lead times per process, with the warehousing and transportation operation teams. To measure the performance then, you just need to spot the failures by comparing the actual performance versus this target. And also, you can estimate when each process should be ending. So for instance, you have the expecting picking date. So when you consider the order creation and transmission target lead times, you can estimate when the warehouse is supposed to receive the order and start to pick. Then you have the requested packing time. It's usually your invoicing team that wants to fix this because when the shipment is supposed to be packed, it will be ready to be invoiced and loaded to the truck. And you have the requested shipping time. So it's the time when we are supposed to hand over the responsibility to the transportation team and the truck is supposed to leave the warehouse. And at the end, the most important KPI, the requested delivery time. This is measuring your end-to-end performance. This is the date where the logistic team is committed to deliver the shipment at the store. For each of these timestamps, you try to be ahead of the target, especially for the delivery. How can you define a lead time by process? That's simple. You just need to measure the time between two timestamps. So the order transfer lead time, so this is basically under the responsibility of IT, is the time between the order creation and the order reception in WMS. The preparation lead time is between the time the order is received and the packing is ended. This is the responsibility of your warehouse team. And you have the shipment lead time, is the time your pallets are waiting for the truck. And then you move to the transportation lead time, so it's from the time your truck is leaving the warehouse until the pallets arrive at the store. And you have also the reception lead time. So from the time goods arrive at the store, how long it takes to the team to receive them in the system. And the most important, your overall end-to-end lead time. The question is, what can impact badly your end-to-end lead time? The answer is cutoff times. How can these cutoff times impact so much your end-to-end lead time? Let's look at them more closely. So the first rule is the order reception. If your order is received after 6 p.m., which is the cutoff time for the order reception, you need to wait another 24 hours for order preparation. You have the same for packing. If your pallet is not ready for 7 p.m., your truck will leave without you and you will have to wait another 24 hours. If the truck, leaving the warehouse, does not arrive before the cutoff time at the airport, you will miss the flight, another 24 hours in your schedule. And finally, if your plane lands after 8 p.m., you will be late for the custom clearance and your shipment will stay in the staging area for the custom clearance the day after. And the most important is the store delivery lead time. So during the last mile delivery, if your truck does not arrive before 4:30 p.m., your store team will not accept the pallet. So you will have to wait the day after to be able to unload. Your end-to-end lead time can be impacted by manual process variability, amplified by the effect of cutoff time. Let's first draw the perfect scenario. The distribution planner creates the replenishment orders at 3 p.m. It's then transmitted to the warehouse where it's prepared, packed, and shipped. This is the first cutoff time. If your shipment is not ready at 7 p.m., you will miss the truck and you will have to wait 24 hours. Then your truck is heading to the airport and arrive 2 hours later. Second cutoff time. If you can't arrive before, you'll miss the flight and your shipment will wait 24 hours. The plane takes off and lands the day after at 6 p.m. You have here the third cutoff time, but now in the perfect scenario, you are okay. And finally, the day after, you start the clearance at 9 a.m. and your truck leaves to the store. So, if everything is going well, your end-to-end lead time is 72 hours. So what could happen if you deviated a bit from this perfect scenario? Let's simulate that. For each process, I added some variability around the target to simulate the reality of operation. From transmission to last mile delivery, we suppose that the lead time is following a normal distribution around the target. I have generated 200 scenarios. For the normal scenario, the total lead time is 72.5 hours. Let us now measure the gap between the ideal result and 200 scenarios simulated with variability in the lead time. Results are split into four categories. First category, all cutoff time are respected. So your lead time is very close to 72.5 hours. It can be lower, but it can be also higher. But nothing here that will really impact your overall performance. Then you have some scenarios that meet one cutoff time. And other scenarios that meet two cutoff times. So here you have plus 24 and plus 48 hours in your total lead time. We're lucky, no scenarios have missed three cutoff times. Now that we have the results, let's conduct the root cause analysis. We are lucky that only 2 out of 5 cutoff times have been missed. Let's now deep dive into each leg of transportation to find root causes. So let's first start with the shipping. For 20 scenarios, we have missed the cutoff time for loading at 7 p.m. And it's mainly because of delays during the pick and pack. Your truck is now heading to the airport. So we are talking about the lead time to take off. And we have the same 20 scenarios with 24 hours delays. Therefore, what we can see is that the transportation from the warehouse to the airport did not cause any late arrival. After landing, you need to be on time for the custom clearance. We have scenarios with plus 48 hours and additional scenarios with 24 hours. This is due to the impact of the flight time. Several shipments arrived after the custom clearance cutoff time. So now we have only the last leg remaining, so we can have a look at the end-to-end lead time. What we can see is that only one scenario is above the red line, which means it has more than 72 hours of lead time. due to 3 cutoff time missed. We have a bit less than 10 scenarios that are close to 48 hours of delay, which is basically 2 cutoff missing. And the majority of scenarios are like around the yellow line, which means more than 24 hours of delay or 1 cutoff time missed. And the rest, near the green line, have all the cutoff time respected, but they have their lead time that is oscillating around the target. So to conclude, in this example, we showed that target lead times are not guaranteed. The scenarios with late deliveries are bringing a lot of instability to the supply chain and draining a lot of energy from the operational teams. You can automate this kind of analysis if your company is developing advanced end-to-end supply chain capabilities. It starts with harmonized data and connected systems. And finally, you need to make sure that your inventory managers are reviewing their assumptions considering this instability. If you have any question or you want to share your own experience of supply chain resilience impacted by process variability, feel free to share them in the comment section.